Goldeneye 007 is finally released, and here's going to be a brief rundown as to what you're getting if you decide to play this game. First things first, this is not a remaster, so I don't want anybody walking into this game disappointed that the graphics don't look all that great. Essentially, this game is an updated version of Goldeneye 007, so virtually it's going to look the same, though it's going to play a little bit better. In terms of how the game looks and plays, it's exactly what I was going to be expecting. I wasn't expecting them to reinvent the wheel here or anything. It just feels like an updated version, a ported version of 007. So now you don't have to boot up an extremely old console to play this game. You can play it right on your Xbox or Switch in this case as well. The addition of achievements is nice, which is honestly what I was looking forward to the most, because honestly, if you're not a speedrunner and you've already played 007, aside from the nostalgia factor, what would you really have to play this game for? Achievements gives you a nice little incentive if you're somebody who actually cares about going for them. Otherwise, if you're playing this game because you have a lot of fond memories of playing the original Goldeneye, then I'm sure that'll scratch the itch for you. After you play it a time or two, will you really be coming back to it super frequently? Not necessarily, but at least it's there and you have the option of playing it on a modern console. For anybody who hasn't played the original game, then you're probably not going to be in for the greatest time in terms from a strictly gameplay perspective, because the gameplay is pretty damn bare bones. Performance-wise, I'm pretty sure the game hovers at about 30 FPS, which is super surprising, because I'm running it on a Series X console, so it definitely shouldn't have a problem from a power perspective in order to get to 60 or 120 FPS. A Switch I can understand running at 30, because the console is not very powerful at all. Also be noted that there are some performance issues. I experienced a little bit of stutter here and there, so there's still some little kinks that can be ironed out. Also keep in mind that online multiplayer is limited to the Switch because for some reason that needed to be an exclusive thing, so if you're looking to play multiplayer on the Xbox version of this, you have to be playing split screen. There is no online multiplayer yet. I think in like a year it's gonna come out. Overall, do I recommend this minor port of 007? Quite honestly, only if you're a fan of the original game, or if you're a Game Pass subscriber. You're not going to get anything super special with this. If you enjoyed the original 007, then I'm sure you're going to enjoy this. From a gameplay perspective, it plays almost exactly the same, just with the addition of modern aiming controls. Of course, the resolution's going to be higher, but the graphics aren't really changed at all, and the gameplay is what you would expect. So if you liked the original game, you're definitely going to like this, and it just gives you an opportunity to play it on modern hardware. If you hadn't played the original 007, then you're probably not going to be in for the most riveting gameplay experience of your life. So realistically, give the game a shot, but don't expect anything groundbreaking. That's going to do it for this quick video here. Thank you guys for sticking around and watching this, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Cheerio, mates!